please subscribe and don't forget to press the bell icon to get notified whenever we upload a new video.
Ashwani, what's the first trade today and what's the bigger trade? Would you want to sell any kind of pullbacks or you think today could be a day of short covering?
Well, good morning. This is not a market where you have trade for the day, etc. If the market is in your favor like it was yesterday, you blast the hell out of it. And on rest of the days, you just hang around. If we are going to open almost flat, even if you do get short covering, it may not be tradable to the upside. So the only scenario where I will trade is, you know, 10,700, 720 if we get there for any reason, or towards 26,500 thereabouts on the Bank Nifty. The trend is down, but you can't take, you know, the trade in the first minute and hope for it to work, because it's still all over the place. There is no clear trend. There are days when it looks like, you know, a great amount of trend has started. On the rest of the days, it's best to stick with individual stocks.
Okay, fair enough. We'll come back to you for those individual stocks, Ashwani. Good morning, Sudarshan. Would you say the same? Not trade the Nifty, or short it if it gives you a little bit of a bounce?
Good morning, Lata. No, my view has been, and since the last 4 days, that we are likely to break this trading range, which we broke yesterday, and we should position ourselves in anticipation by buying put options for July. That has been a consistent theme and that continues. July should see lower levels. So the big trade is in the as a positional trader, because intraday choppiness is avoided when you take a position and hopefully the market obliges. So even now, nothing is lost. If you don't have put options for July, essentially a bearish call, buy them. 10,700 now strikes and stay with the trend. This, it's going to be choppy. This is a correction. It's not a clear downtrend. So a correction normally goes down, moves up, again goes down and creates a lot of volatility. But the direction is downward. So stay with that direction for the positional view. But for today, I think the markets can surprise us again by actually moving up. I would be a buyer on any intraday dip. This is a pure intraday trade. The positional view is bearish.
The positional view is bearish. Mitesh, would you concur with that, that it's better to buy puts in this market because it's heading downwards?
Yeah, good morning. So I think, breaking below 10,700 clearly suggested that there should be some kind of a downward bias. I expect 10,600, 590 to be tested to begin with. And if those levels break, we could see even further downside. So keeping that kind of view in the mind, I would be comfortable buying into put options. We get a 20-30 point, I think we'll be comfortable selling futures also. Closer to about 10,695, 700 zone, with a stop about 10,725. I think 10,600 remains the first target, but eventually there is a risk that we might even break below that.
Oh, okay. I see.
Ashwani, let's discuss individual stocks then. What's on your list?
See, it's clear that, PSU banks have the most amount of momentum on the downside. So you have to get short. And like I said, most of them will be two-digit. Now, maybe at some point I'll have to revise even the two-digit numbers. So, basically the money that's coming out of there is getting into strong retail private banks. So you could have, PSUs down and retail private banks going up. So that way, Shrey Infra is a sell with a stop of 66, target of 58. REC is a sell with a stop of 105, target of 97. Bank of India is a sell with a stop of 90, target of 84. These are safer sells because nobody will try to cover their shorts or, no huge buying is expected, but still try to sell once the market rallies a little bit. On the buying side, Auro Pharma is a buy with a stop of 612, target of 630. And Jet Airways is showing a fresh breakdown now. That's a sell with a stop of 359, target of 344.